I got this piece of 4 to 20 milliamps current to voltage converter model. Let's see how it functions with the Arduino Nano. But first, a quick review of the purpose of this model. 4 to 20 milliamps is the most common means of transmitting industrial instrumentation analog signals. Industrial instruments such as level, pressure, flow, and temperature transmitters measure process variables with output of millivolts from their sensors. These transmitters convert the millivolt signal to milliamp and then transmit the measured signal with two wires over some distance. They use 24 volts DC power supply over the same two wires to form a 4 to 20 milliamps current loop. The choice of process signal transmission with current instead of voltage is to eliminate signal loss. Voltage loss over a pair of wires increases with distance due to the increased wire resistance, with current remaining constant. 4 milliamps represents the lower range value and 20 milliamps the upper range value. Thus, a pressure transmitter of range 0 to 100 psi will transmit 4 to 20 milliamps current, which will then be converted to voltage by the required controller module. Here is where the current to voltage converter is required. The current comes in through these terminals, and 5 volts maximum comes out through these terminals to the Arduino Nano. Power is supplied between these points. The product information stated voltage range of 7 to 36 volts. I'm going to power the module with a 12 volt power supply. At this point, it's an LED to indicate power supply to the module. These two jumpers are for the selection of the output voltage. I will leave it as it is for 5 volt output. This regulator is for adjusting the zero limit output voltage, while this is for the maximum or span. The first thing to do is to calibrate the output voltage range with this 4 to 20 milliamps current source. Now I'm connecting 12 volts power supply cables to this point. Positive here and the negative here. I am also connecting the positive probe of my multimeter set to measure current to this terminal and the negative probe here. Now, adjusting the knob from 0 to 100%, notice the corresponding reading on the meter from 4 to 20 milliamps. I will now connect the current source output to the input of the converter. Positive connected to positive, negative connected to negative. Also connected the 12 volt power supply and leave for some time to stabilize. Then I am setting the multimeter to measure the output voltage. At 0% on the current source, the voltmeter should display 0. If not, adjust to 0 here with a small flat screwdriver. Set the current source to 100% and adjust the span to 5 volt output. You can repeat these steps to ensure consistent reading. The module output will now be connected to the analog inputs of the Arduino Nano. This circuit diagram is from one of my tutorial videos on LDmicro programming. See link in the description. I have modified the logic to display the raw values from the ADC. At 0% on the current source, corresponding to 4 milliamps, 0 should be displayed. And at 100% corresponding to 20 milliamps, 123 should be displayed. Now, this temperature transmitter ranging from 0 to 100 degrees Celsius will be connected to the input of the module. The positive power supply is connected to the positive terminal of the temperature transmitter. The negative terminal of the transmitter is then connected to the module input positive terminal. The module input negative terminal is finally connected to the negative power supply. This is what is called the 4 to 20 milliamps current loop. I have made more changes to the logic to display the temperature reading on the LCD. The ADC reading is multiplied by 5 volts and 100 degrees Celsius and then divided by 1023. But we want to keep this calculation within 2 bytes of data memory. So 99 degrees C will be used, and the equation is simplified to ADC reading multiplied by 3 and then divided by 31. This mode instruction calculates the decimal point reading. Values to the left of the decimal point are displayed by this instruction, and these to the right. This lower branch removes space between the decimal points and the single digit after decimal point value. And here we have the display of the temperature transmitter. Please click on the like button if this tutorial is helpful to you. Leave a comment below and subscribe to this channel if you have not. Bye for now.